Well, a large plume of subtropical moisture has already started to move into the central coast. Here's a look at the coastline from earlier today. That overcast is going to be a trend over the next week. Along with that, we have some light showers and drizzle moving through the area that's going to continue through the night. But what we're most concerned about is going to be tomorrow's rain. Now you can see this light to moderate rainfall here continuing through the evening, really moving towards Bakersfield right now. But for tomorrow, we have a flash flood watch in effect until Tuesday afternoon in San Luis Obispo and Santa Barbara counties, as well as Ventura County. The most areas of concern are going to be the burn scar areas, including Thomas, Sherpa, Whittier, and Alamo Fire burn scar areas. As we mentioned before, that rainfall can come at a rate of 1/2 inch per hour or 0.7 inch per hour, particularly in the Santa Barbara area. And that threshold for the possibility of seeing the debris flow and mudslides that we saw on January 9th, that's about 0.5 inch per hour. So there's high confidence there that the rain will exceed that threshold. Here's a look at the microclimate model showing some of that rainfall tomorrow. This area in yellow is moderate to heavy rainfall. Now we're expecting that to be continuing through the afternoon hours and then starting to move out by Tuesday afternoon. By Wednesday, we're looking at a possible clearing in some of those showers, still relatively unsettled in most spots. On Thursday, we have another storm on the way that's going to be just on the heels of Tuesday's storm. It's expected to bring cooler temperatures and stronger winds. In the long term, possibility of another wet weekend ahead of us. Now we're looking at the possibility of the accumulation in Santa Barbara County right around 1.5 inches by Tuesday. Other areas, we're not looking at as much. We're looking at about 0.5 inch of rain in Paso Robles and Cambria, 34 in San Luis Obispo, just about 1/4 inch in Santa Maria, and right around just 1/10 inch in other spots like Goleta. As we're looking at the long term here, but the other storm moving in by Thursday, we could be seeing up to 0.5 inch or more in most areas like Cambria, 1.5 inches, Paso about 1 inch more, San Luis Obispo pretty close to that, 0.8 inches. Now those current conditions as we're moving into tonight, relatively mild conditions, especially in those overnight hours, close to 60 degrees in Santa Barbara, Gaviota at 58 tonight, 60 in San Luis Obispo, and 60 in the North County. Now the forecast for tomorrow, we're really not changing the temperatures a whole lot. And again, we can expect those overcast conditions and most of those rain showers through your Monday or your Tuesday morning commute rather. 63 degrees in Paso for tomorrow, 64 in San Luis Obispo, 62 in Santa Barbara. Those overnight temperatures staying in the 50s, 62 for Cuyama, 63 in the Santa Ynez area, the Five Cities area, also into the low 60s along with the North Coast. And here's a look at the next 5 days. We're really looking at unsettled weather for 5 days straight here. These temperatures going to be stretching into the high 50s for both Santa Maria and Santa Barbara. San Luis Obispo seeing temperatures close to 58 for the daytime highs. So it is going to be a cool week ahead and an unsettled week ahead. The most danger, though, is going to be coming with Tuesday early morning through the afternoon hours. Karina?